हेलो एवरीवन, आई पुनीत उपाध्याय, एचओडी ऑफ मैकेनिकल डिपार्टमेंट, जैन पॉलिटेक्निक, बेलगावी, डीलिंग विद द सब्जेक्ट ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग. सो इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द चैप्टर नोन एज ऑटोमोबाइल इंजन सिस्टम. सो व्हाट विल बी कवर्ड इन दिस सेशन? फर्स्ट वन, व्हाट इज एन ऑटोमोबाइल, टाइप्स ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल, इंडियन मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल्स, कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ एन ऑटोमोबाइल, इंजन, मेन पार्ट्स ऑफ एन इंजन, इंजन मेंटेनेंस, डिसमेंटलिंग एन इंजन, इंस्पेक्शन ऑफ इंजन कंपोनेंट्स, देन मोस्ट लाइकली क्वेश्चंस फॉर एन एग्जामिनेशन. सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग यू शुड नो व्हाट इज एन ऑटोमोबाइल. सो हियर एन ऑटोमोबाइल इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ सेल्फ प्रोपेल्ड व्हीकल व्हिच इज यूज्ड फॉर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ अ पैसेंजर्स एंड गुड्स ऑन द ग्राउंड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ एन ऑटोमोबाइल सच एज एन स्कूटर, कार, ट्रक, विच आर द मोस्ट कॉमन एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ एन ऑटोमोबाइल्स विच आर यूज इन डे टू डे लाइफ टू मेक एन ईज फॉर एन ह्यूमन बींग टू ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू एन अदर पॉइंट सो दैट ही रीचेज द डेस्टिनेशन विद इन द प्रिस्क्राइब लिमिटेड ऑफ द टाइम. नेक्स्ट, द टाइप्स ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल्स. दे आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल्स. फर्स्ट वन इज बेस्ड ऑन द पर्पज. सो वॉट इज पर्पज? दे मेनली थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ पर्पज. फर्स्ट वन इज द पैसेंजर व्हीकल्स, सेकेंड वन इज द गुड्स व्हीकल, third one is a special purpose vehicles. So what are these passenger vehicles? Passenger vehicles are used primarily for transportation of passengers. As the name itself indicates, there are buses, cars, autos, trains, auto rickshaws, which come under these categories. Next one is the goods vehicles. Goods vehicles are primarily used for transportation of goods from one place to another place. The delivery of goods must be in time and no damages must be incurred. Examples such as lorries, material carriers come under this category. Next one is the special purpose. Special purpose vehicles are used only in certain times. These special purpose vehicles comes under emergency times, recession times, and much more. Next one, based on load capacity. There are two types, light duty vehicles and heavy duty vehicles. What is this light duty vehicle? The light duty vehicles such as a scooter, bikes, autos, cars, and much more. Heavy duty vehicles include the trucks, lorries, tractors, and many more. Next, based on fuel used. Basically, you know that normally nowadays you can see the fuel such as in petrol engine vehicles, diesel engine vehicles, gas vehicles, then electrical vehicles. These are the four important types of vehicles which we find. So what is petrol engine vehicles? Vehicles that uses a petrol as a type of fuel consumption such as in bikes. Some of the cars come under these categories. Diesel engine vehicles, vehicles that are used as diesel as a type of fuel consumptions. Many buses, trucks and cars come under this category. Gas vehicles, vehicles that uses a gas, a type of fuel consumptions. Turbine powered cars come under this category. Next one is the electric vehicles. Vehicles that use a electric current as a type of fuel consumptions. Electric cars, electric bikes, electric buses come under this category. Next one. Based on drive of the vehicles. Basically, there are two types of drives, left-hand drive and the right-hand drive. So, normally in India, we use the right-hand drive. What is this left-hand drive? Left-hand drive is nothing but when the steering wheel is fitted in the left hand, this type of vehicles are used in left-hand drive vehicles. What is this right-hand drive? When the steering wheel is fitted to the right hand, this type of vehicles is called as a right-hand vehicles. Next one, based on number of wheels and axles. Basically, they are you can consider normally four types of wheels. First one, two wheelers, three wheelers, four wheelers, six wheelers. Okay, depending upon this, the axle varies. Two wheelers, such as many motorcycles, bikes, bicycles, and many more come under this category. Three wheelers, mainly auto rickshaws, autos, and special three wheelers come under this category. Four wheelers, car, buses, jeeps, many trucks come under this category. Six wheelers, many buses and trucks are equipped with six wheels. Two wheels on the front and four wheels on the back. Four wheels help to balance and control the acceleration and disturbance while carrying a huge load. Based on type of transmission, there are basically three types of transmissions: automatic transmission vehicles, manual transmission vehicles, and semi-automatic transmission vehicles. What is automatic transmission vehicles? Vehicles that are capable of changing the gears automatically within the respect of to the speed are known as the automatic transmission vehicles, such as in BMW cars, Audi cars, Skoda, Nissan. Okay, there are some of the automatic transmission vehicles. What is manual transmission vehicles? Vehicles that are not capable of changing gears automatically with respect to a speed are known as a manual transmission vehicles. Many Maruti and Tata cars come under this category. Next one is semi-automatic transmission vehicles. Vehicles that transmit or change gears manually by changing with a clutch are known as a semi-automatic transmission vehicles. Based on suspension type used in a vehicle. Conventional system, then independent system. In conventional system, we find as a leaf spring type of suspension system, and independent system we find as a coil spring and pneumatic type of suspension system. Next one, according to the position of an engine, there are two types, front and rear. So what is the front? When the engine is loaded in the front side of vehicle, it is known as front position vehicle. When the engine is loaded in the rear side of vehicle, it is called as a rear position vehicles. So these are the different types of the automobiles. Next one, Indian manufacturer of an automobiles. First one, the scooters. Under scooters, we find as Andhra Pradesh scooters, such as in Vespa, okay, or Pushpaka. Next one, API scooters. Then Bajaj Auto. Bajaj, we can find different types of these scooters. Next one, motorcycles. So in motorcycles, we can find as the Bajaj Auto, then Hyundai Motors, then Hero Honda, then TVS. And what is a moped as a non-gearless vehicles? Okay, in this we find as Kinetic Engineering, Majestic Auto, Mopeds India. Next one is the cars, Hindustan Motor Ambassadors, Contessa, Maruti Udyog, then Premier Automobiles as well, Premier Padmani. Then next one, Jeeps, Mahindra, buses, we can find Ashok Leyland, Premier Automobiles, Hindustan Motors. Trucks, we can find Ashok Leyland, Premier Automobiles, Hindustan Motors. Okay, so these are the types of the manufacturers. Next one, components of an automobile. The main units of an automobile are the basic structure. So what is this basic structure? So the structure is nothing but the load carrying capacity. So what is the basic structure? This is one of the unit on which are built the remainder of the units required to turn into an power operated vehicles. It consists of the frame, the suspension system, the axles, the wheels and the tires. Next one, the power plant. What is this power plant? The power plant provides the motive power for all the various functions which the vehicles or any part of it may be called as upon the to perform. The power plant generally consists of an internal combustion engine, which may be either of spark ignition or a compression ignition type. Next one, the transmission system. So what is this transmission system? Transmission system is system which helps the vehicle to transmit the power from one part to the another part. Next one, the auxiliaries. The auxiliaries, the principal one of these are in that is common to almost all types of vehicles. That is in the electrical equipments. This may be subdivided into four systems: the supply system, the battery and generator, the starter, the ignition system, the battery and magneto ignition, then ancillary devices. Next one, the controls. The consists of mainly the steering system and the brakes. Next one, the superstructure. In some of the cases where frameless construction is not adopted, there must be a separate superstructure, the body attached to the frame, which in case of a frameless construction, the body performs the function of both. The body contains the passengers and the luggage space besides the engine compartment. The shape of the body depends upon the ultimate use of the which the vehicle is meant. So these are the components of an automobile. Next comes the main parts, that is the engine. Normally you can see this is the engine where there are different parts which are shown in the engine. So you can see here the cylinder, okay, the coil, the carburetor, the dynamo, the oil sump. So this is the oil sump, the crankshaft, flywheel, connecting rod, exhaust pump. So from this we are going to study the main parts which are required for the engine. So now before that, you should know what is an engine. The engine is a device which converts chemical energy of a fuel into mechanical energy. So it is the heart of a modern automobile. It is made by various parts bolted together and they all work together to achieve power by burning of a fuel. Each part in internal combustion engine has its own function and significance. If any parts fail, the working of engine is not possible. It is highly recommended to always keep your engine at optimum level, and this can be achieved with proper service at a regular interval of time. So now we are going to study the engine parts one by one. So this is the explanation of an engine which we have discussed. Next one. First one, the cylinder block. So this is a figure which is related to the cylinder block. So this first one, we are going to know what is the cylinder block. Cylinder block basically made up of a cast iron and or any aluminium alloys. So what is a cylinder block? Cylinder block or cylinder are the main parts of an engine. It is the part in which the combustion of a fuel takes place. All other parts like piston, connecting rod, crankshaft, water jack, etc. are bolted on into it. So you can see here in this, we can see the piston can be placed. So this is the main part of a cylinder block. So this is the explanation. Next one is the piston. So this is the piston. So what is this piston? The piston is basically made up of the cast or aluminium alloy. So piston is placed in the cylinder and transmit thrust to the connecting rod. It is free to move. It compresses the air fuel mixture and converts the fuel energy into mechanical energy. It transmits the power to the crankshaft. So this is the piston. Next one, cylinder head. Basically the cylinder head is made up of the aluminium. Cylinder head is fitted on top of the cylinder block, and function of the cylinder head is to seal the working end of a cylinder and not to permit entry and exit of gases, and covers head walls of an engine. The walls, the spark plugs, the camshaft, etc. are fitted on it. So this is the cylinder head. Next one, connecting rod. The connecting rod are basically made up of a drop forced out steel. Okay, this connecting rod, the connecting piston to the crankshaft, and transmits the motion and thrust of piston to the crankshaft. So it connects the piston to the crankshaft and then transmit the motion and thrust of piston to the crankshaft. The lower end of the connecting rod is connected to the piston and the bigger end is connected to the crankshaft. So this lower end is connected. So this is called the lower end. So lower end is connected to the piston and the bigger end is connected to the crankshaft. So this is the explanation. Next one, crankshaft. Basically the crankshaft are made up of the steel. So what is this crankshaft? It is located in the bottom end of the cylinder block. It transmits the reciprocating motion of a piston into the rotary motion. This rotary motion used to rotate the wheels of the vehicles. So normally you can see here, okay, in this the connecting rod is placed, okay, in between the slots, and with this connecting rod the piston is placed there, so that it transmits the reciprocating rotary motion which is used to drive the wheels of the vehicle. Next one, oil sump. So basically this is a oil sump. What is the oil sump? It is used for collection of the oil. So it is made up of the aluminium alloy. It is bolted at the lower end of the cylinder block. All the oil of the lubricating the movable parts is placed in it. So what all the lubrication need to be done in the engine parts, all it is done in placed in this oil sump. So next one, crankshaft. This camshaft. The camshaft is made up of the steel. So what is this camshaft? The camshaft is a shaft to which a cam is fastened, or which a cam forms an integral part. In internal combustion engine with piston, the camshaft used to operate poppet valves. It consists of a cylindrical rod running the length of the cylinder bank with a number of oblong lobes protruding from it, one from each wall. The cam lobes forces the wall open by pressing on the wall or on some intermediate mechanism as they rotate. So this is the explanation of the crankshaft. Next one, the valves. So these are the valves. So valves, the valves are basically made up of a carbon steel alloys. It is fitted on the cylinder head. It regulates the flow of air fuel mixture inside the cylinder and exhaust gas outside the cylinder block. When both the inlet and exhaust valves are closed, no pressure can go inside or outside the cylinder head. So this is the valve diagram. Okay, basically they are used to maintain the air fuel mixture in the engine. So this explanation of the valves. Next one, spark plug. So what is a spark plug? As you know, the spark plug are used for starting of the engine. So it is a spark ignition engine. It is basically used in petrol engines. It is fitted on the cylinder head. It is used to ignite the air fuel mixture inside a cylinder at the end each compression strokes. So this is the spark plug which you basically find in the petrol engines. Next one, the injector. What is the injector? It is used in the diesel engine. Compression is also known as a compression ignition engine. It is fitted on the cylinder head. It is used to inject fuel in the spray from inside the cylinder at the end of the compression stroke. So basically it is used to compress the ignition type. Okay, that is sprays the fuel from inside the cylinder at the end of the compression stroke. So this is the explanation. So next one, engine maintenance. So whenever you purchase any vehicles, okay, it may be the bikes or the car, there must be a certain maintenance. So if you regularly maintain the desired vehicle, whichever the vehicle which you have purchased, then it may sustain for the longer period of the time. So what is this maintenance? Maintenance means keeping all the systems and features functioning as possible to the manufacturer original design. Maintenance helps the vehicles to start and run and stop as the manufacturer intended, so that a maximum amount of performance, reliability and service life are achieved. So why this? What is the purpose of this maintenance? First one, to keep the vehicle in the good running conditions. So if you regularly maintain, you see that the vehicle is running in a good condition. Next one, to keep the operate costless. So if you maintain properly, the operation cost will be less. Next one, to provide safety on vehicle operations. So it will be safer enough to drive. Next one, to give feedback to manufacturer for development and rectifications. So regular maintenance, okay, it gives the feedback. So where is the fault? So you can easily find out and rectify it. To adhere to the legal requirements of the vehicle operations. So this regarding the engine maintenance. Basically, you can see there are different types of maintenance, such as a preventive maintenance or predictive maintenance or breakdown maintenance. What is the preventive maintenance? Preventive maintenance, it is a scheduled type of the planned maintenance action aimed to prevention of the breakdowns and failures. So what is this? Next one is the predictive maintenance. Predictive maintenance means you are predicting something that this is going to happen. Okay, so you are predicting before it happens. That is nothing but the predictive maintenance. Okay, so these are the types of the maintenance. Next one, this dismantling an engine. So there are certain procedures if you want to dismantle the engine. So first one, remove cylinder head. So first one point is to remove the cylinder head. Next one, take off an external accessories like motor, dynamo, ignition unit or the injection pump. Remove engine sump. Next one, rake off timing gear cover after removing pulleys. Next one, remove clutch unit. Take off the valves with the tappets, rocker arms, push rods, etc. Remove connecting rod caps, pistons and connecting rods. Take off timing chain and remove sprockets. Remove crankshaft with a flywheel by taking off main bearing caps. Remove camshafts. If necessary, drive out valve guides. Disconnect oil sump drive and remove oil sump at a most convenient stage in proceedings. So these are the basic okay, points which we need to be considered while dismantling an engine. Next one, inspection of an engine components. So what is this inspection? Inspection is nothing but a regular checking of an engine components, whether the parts is running as per the standard demands, as per the operations or no. So often is carefully scribing of various engine parts will reveal indications of damage, excessive wear, surface cracks and other defects without the need of more elaborate inspection. So first one, the simple parts such as the studs, bolts and nuts should be examined for signs of damage or stripping. The next, the nuts can be run down the threads as a check. Bolts, nuts and washer faces must be free from the edge burrs. So edge burrs should be free. The walls, the springs, the collars and retainers are the examined for the wear and shape. The piston should be carefully inspected for surface damage and for wear effects in the ring grooves on the skirt portion, etc. Blackened areas on the land or skirt denotes area of a gash blow by, and these are the to be noted. The piston crown should be examined for cracks or distortion and the pinholes for signs of hammering effect. The big end bearing of the connecting rod and the journals of the crankshaft are inspected for signs of cracking, curing or other surface defects. Next one, the camshaft bearings and journals are also checked. The timing gear teeth will indicate by visuals and machine test whether an individual damage or wear has occurred. Similarly, conditions of a timing chains, rocket teeth are also checked. So these are the main parts of the inspection of the engine components. At last, we should see that most likely questions for an examinations. So there are basically 8 questions where the students need to focus for the examinations. Thank you.